Welcome back. I hope you are enjoying the coding journey with us, and I hope you have already watched my previous video, which was about sequences. Today, in this session, we will do some hands-on exercises about sequences. Are you ready? Please open your code.org account. There is a video which I have already posted about it. Watch it and open your code.org account. The link is there in the description box. Yeah, and in case you have not seen my previous video about sequences, the link is again there in the description box. Please watch it. So let's get started. Very first step is to log into your code.org account. I believe you have already created your account. And I believe you have also added a course, maybe Express Reader or Pre-Express Reader. Today, we will take some exercises from Express course. We will do some exercises from lesson number 1 and lesson number 3. Let's get started. I will directly start from exercise number 7. Once you do exercise number 7 and other, the kids should be able to do the previous exercises themselves. So I'm starting directly with exercise number 7. Do it along with me. This is what I will recommend. Let me read the instructions. What does the instruction say? Instruction says, keep calm and help me find the bad pig. Otherwise, I might get angry. Get the bird to the pig and avoid the TNTs. So before we start giving the instructions, before we start putting the instruction blocks into the workspace, let me tell you what does these instructions or what does these commands do. This command, move forward, this will give the instruction to the pig to move forward by one space. Turn left will give the instruction to the pig to turn left at a 90 degree angle. And this turn right will also give the instruction to the angry bird to turn right towards 90 degree. This repeat block we will see later. Now for the convenience of you guys, I will be going step by step. Do it along with me and understand what is happening with each command which we are giving into this workspace. So purposely, first I will try to give some wrong commands to tell you what happens. When run, I'm saying move forward and let me see what happens. It is facing towards a block which is non-accessible to it. So that is why it is banging its head. So what we will have to do? First, we will have to give it the instruction to go towards the direction where there is a way. So we will have to give the instruction to an angry bird to turn towards left and then move forward. Let's see what happens. Yeah, now it moves forward. Again, we will have to give the instruction to turn right and then 3 steps forward. Let's see where does it goes. I hope you guys are able to follow me. If not, pause the video, take a look how it is going, where it is going, and then move ahead. Again, turn right and then move forward. One another thing, whenever you are doing any changes in your code, you will have to click on reset and then. Yeah, so this puzzle is completed. Next, we'll move on to puzzle number 8. It is a challenge puzzle. It says this code has got a lot of bugs. You will need to remove some blocks and add others. So to understand which block is wrong, we can take help of this button, which is a step button. What does this step button do? When we click on this step button, only the command which is next will be executed and then it will stop until we click on the step button again. So it helps us to understand what is wrong, where it is wrong, and how we can fix it. So let's see this step button as well. I am clicking on a step button, and you can see this block, move forward, is highlighted. So this seems to be right. This angry bird is moving in the right direction. Again a step, this also seems to be right. Again a step, it turned towards right. This also seems to be correct. Move forward seems to be right. Again, I am clicking on a step button. This step is wrong. This particular block is wrong. So what I will do, I will remove this block from here. I will reset and I will again start from step. This time I can go a little faster because we know at least till here this is right. Yeah, so till now turn left. This also seems to be right. Move forward is right. Turn right also seems to be correct. Move forward. This also seems to be correct. One another move forward seems to be correct. Now, this last move forward does not seem to be correct. So I will keep it also aside. Actually, we should delete them. We should never keep an unused code. So here you can see this angry bird actually needs to move towards right. So let me put the block of towards right, turn right, and see what happens. This time I directly clicked on run because I do not need to go step by step. Yeah, turn right is correct and then move forward. Let me reset and run it again and see if we successfully completed this challenge or not. Yeah, this challenge is completed. Let's move on to the next puzzle. I am directly jumping on to the puzzle number 11 now. Okay, help me sneak up on the pig any way you want to. Here you can see there is a lot of green ground. The angry bird can reach out to pig in many possible directions. So we will have to pick a direction which is the shortest route. So if you want to understand it in the language of computer science, the different routes via which this angry bird could reach out to pig are known as different algorithms to perform the similar task. So we will try to figure out the shortest way so that my program is shortest and more efficient as well. Let me take an opportunity to introduce repeat block as well here with you guys. So what does this repeat block do? We will do a complete session on repeat block later on, but for now you just understand, if there are repetitive commands, instead of putting those commands multiple times, you can put that particular command inside a repeat block and say how many times you want that command to be executed. So here, we want this angry bird to move forward 3 times. Instead of writing move forward 3 times, what we will do? We will put this repeat block here. We will just say move forward and repeat it 3 times. Let's see what happens. Yeah, that seems to be right. The next instruction has to be to turn right and then again go 3 steps forward. Again, I'm using the repeat block. Let's see where does it reaches. Yep. What next? Again, Angry Bird needs to turn towards the pick, so it has to move towards, it has to turn towards left. Turn left and then again three steps forward. Let's see. Yes, so we completed this puzzle. Great. I hope you are enjoying these coding exercises along with me. Take a pause if you want to and then move along. Now we will do some exercises from lesson number 3. We will do exercise number 6. Okay, so here in lesson number 3, as you can see, they have introduced one more command, collect. Yeah, so what does this exercise says? This exercise says to collect each bit of treasure. And these blocks are kept in the wrong order and we need to fix the order. Now again, to analyze what's the problem in the order of these blocks, we will use this step button. So I'm clicking on a step and I will try to see where it is actually wrong. Yeah, so the second block does not seem to be right because there is no treasure to collect. I will remove this collect and again, I will step it. I will reset and step. Again, the instruction says collect, though there is no treasure. So this is wrong. We will remove this collect again from here, reset and step. Okay, so although it is moving forward, but there are no command to collect the treasure. So we will have to place these two collect blocks which we just removed in the correct order. So this time I will reset and I will directly click on run command. Yeah, we completed this puzzle as well. Hope you enjoyed this code along session with me. Hope you enjoyed all the exercises. So what I will suggest, please complete this lesson 1 and lesson 3 and move on to my next session, which is about debugging. We will have a complete exercise about debugging. Let's do one another exercise here. Maybe we can pick the challenge exercise from here. Yeah, this gate one is the challenge exercise. Let's do that exercise. So kids, please try out other exercises yourself. Make sure you complete lesson 1 and lesson 3. Challenge. What is wrong? What is going on here? Even if we put these in the right order, these will still be some missing. Use blocks from the toolbox to collect all the treasures. So let's see what is going on. Yeah, this seems to be wrong at the very first line only. So we will have to put it in the right order. Let me reset and see what needs to be done. So yeah, the first step has to be move forward, then collect, again move forward, then again collect, again move forward, and then again collect. Turn right, move forward, collect. We have reached till this gem. Let me see if it is right or not. And then I will go ahead and for the further instructions. Yeah, this is right. After this, again, we will say move forward. Move forward. Turn right. Move forward. And collect. See, this is wrong. Here, this is not turn right. This has to be turn left. Yeah, so this challenge puzzle is completed. Friends, I hope you have a lot of fun. Complete the other exercises which we did not complete it in this session. I believe you must have got a fair idea what needs to be done. Complete at least lesson 1 and lesson 3 and see you in my next session, which is on debugging. So get ready for it.